Oh hey, I didn't see you there. Today we are DIYing some cakes for a little kid. So I've got my couple of cake rounds that I've already created. They are lemon with some raspberries in there. So we're just gonna slop them down here to start the process. Don't mind all the other baking. It's just one of those days when the carbs come to stay. And what we're gonna do is we have both our rounds. I'm still moving a little fast, don't mind me. We'll just frost it up, cut it up, and then get the whole shape going. The plan is to build a unicorn cake for, well, that's for me, let's be honest. This one's for me. So as with any cake, we gotta have a nice thin layer in the middle. Frosting and jam is what I'm going to do. Although I've been told that just jam is probably more appropriate. It's all right. It's no fun if you're not messing it up. So here we go. So while I'm frosting this cake, let me tell you all about the macros on a cake like this. Yeah, they're terrible. Terrible macros. But delicious good time. All right, first initial crumb coat. Jam, only the nicest of jams for me. So this one is from Costco. Let's do a thin layer, so no one wants a wet cake. Yeah. And we'll speed this part up in post, so you won't have to sit through the agonizing slowness that is me making cake. But yeah, I made this cake on a challenge. I said I want to build my kids' cake. And I was challenged, saying that there were some doubters. Didn't think I could do a decent job. So this is me showing them up. And if it's terrible, the birthday's not for 3 days, so plenty of time to buy a cake. All right, and we just frost most of, oh wait, before I frost it, we are making a unicorn. So it's gotta have a horn, which we'll cut out here. Oh, it's so soft and delicate. Lovely. And we'll get the shape of the horn. Like so. Yeah. I'm gonna put it on top of head. There we go. Give a little bit better shape to the unicorn's schnoz. There we go. And I guess this will be an ear. Lovely. So an ear, we have a horn. This is going to be the unicorn neck, nose. All right. It's messy. It's ugly. It's going to make a little six-year-old happy. All right. So now we just dump all the frosting on. It's gonna be a unicorn. What? Gotta add nose. I have a special detail I'm thinking about adding to the horn right here. That's right. That's for the older kids. Now the older kids are gonna appreciate the unicorn. That's the detail we want for the unicorn horn, yeah? Older kids and or sons will appreciate that. All right, hit me one more time. That's the first frosting. I'm gonna go get some more smaller stuff, add some berries, add some rainbow marshmallows as a main. This thing's gonna be amazing. Yeah, that's
did.
So in the end, it looks a little bit more like a creepy sort of monster, especially with the eye that ended up going there. But you know what? The kid whose birthday it is says it looks wonderful and they wouldn't mind if this was their actual birthday cake. So yeah, it's gonna be delicious. I'll let you know. And in about 10 minutes, it's dead. Not gonna lie, the frosting is what made this thing happen. The cake was just box cake. The marshmallows, The cutting, But the kid who I made it for, yeah.